Different types of burns. We're going to go ahead and put a graphic up and show some of the different types of burns, because there are different types of people need to understand exactly what they are and the differences. Let's go through them.
Yeah.
If you would explain, please, a thermal burn.
So a thermal burn refers to when there's heat exchange, and it's really, it could be related to your flames or just even the contact from a hot heating pad. So it's a transfer of energy or heat into the soft tissue that will result in thermal burns. And it's the common thing that we see. You get, you know, you can get a scald, hot water, hot coffee. That would be the transfer of heat or even extreme cold that will result in this type of burn.
Radiation burn.
Radiation burn, the most common that we see, it refers to the transfer of ionizing energy. So the most common one that we see is actually the sun. And here in Miami, it happens a lot. South Florida and this area, people go get exposed, and that's the most common source of radiation injury that we see. The other situation where we see sometimes radiation injuries is a patient that are undergoing a radiation therapy. And this is guided, something that we work together with the physicians in nuclear medicine, but we get to see some of that as well.
Chemical burns.
Chemical burns are usually in the industry. And essentially, chemical burns refer, anybody who's working, usually you'll see the household chemicals like your Drano, which is a very strong alkaline, or patients who work in the metal industry. Anybody who works with metal, things to clean metal, they're very heavy acids, strong acids. So this will result in those chemical burns. Essentially, the transferring of ions, which is essentially hydrogen, et cetera, which is part of the components of the chemical.
My dad was a master electrician, and I learned early about electrical burns when I used to go out working with him, and I got shocked a few times. Give us your idea of
electrical burns refer to the transfer of electricity and how electricity conducts to your body. So we are conductors, so we can pass electricity in our body. Unfortunately, one of the things that happens is that as electricity passes through your body, you know, there's a resistance, and this resistance generates heat. So while you're having an electrical burn, this current can pass through your body, and you'll feel the shock of the electricity, but the same thing, this heat is going to be generated in your body. And one of the things with electrical burns is that you might have what looks like a superficial injury, but you have a deep injury that goes through your body as the electricity passes. So the electrical burns are very tricky.